Just on the other side is the mire, the starling assured her. There's a good chance your uncle's still there. Did you hear that? The starling seemed anxious. I've ruffled enough leaves in these parts. I can't be seen with you. I'll catch up with you later. Just don't go and die on me. A whisper echoed through the trees.
Fought like someone who has stolen our champion's power.
A small, yet fantastical band of sprites emerged surrounding Quill.
I'm Veda, root seer of the mire, and
She sized up Quill with a rueful gaze, then turned her attention upward. Quill stepped closer.
Where is my uncle? If you...
Your uncle once took a soft...
Take... was Quill's favorite story. How Sir Argus fought beside the Sprite Champion to seal this temple from the Arcane and secured the survival of their kinds. Simply standing in their heroic footsteps felt like a great honor. Quill hoped this was a shortcut to the castle. What she found was a strange and vibrant place shrouded in perpetual twilight. But something about it was oddly familiar.
Infested.
A grumble echoed from the cave.
And why would I do that?
It croaked loudly, annoyed at either nothing or something.
You in there!
Declared Quill boldly.
Where are we? I'm looking for the fastest way to the castle.
Quill recognized the toad as Veda's steed from the mire. Seemingly oblivious to Quill, he continued.
Fine. I'll open the route. Give them your fancy test. But you're only digging yourself a deeper grave with Rootseer Veda.
If Veda knew I led you here, she'd burn my roots from existence.
A voice rose from the soil, gently shaking the branches.
But I need to know you can handle the perils of the castle.